Hi, and in today's video, I'm going to be showing you how you can convert any image, landscape or portrait into a square one by one image and also align everything perfectly. So come to the Canva homepage. I'm going to go to Create a Design. And for this demonstration, I'm just going to select an A4 document. So to achieve this quickly and efficiently, we're going to use something called frames, which is really easy. So if we just go to Elements, and we go to the top here and just type in frames and press enter. The top here you'll see frames and then just click see all. Now frames are basically a placeholder. They're something that you insert and then when you put an image in, it will crop that image perfectly to the frame you've chosen. So you can see we've got lots of frames here of lots of different shapes and sizes and also an array of different collages. Now you do have to be a little careful because some of these can look like they're squares or simple circles, but actually there's something else there. So for example, you can see here there is a little tear across here, and so that will have an impact on how the photo looks. And you can also see there's some lines here. Again, that will have an impact on the photo. So we just need to scroll down and find a plain square image. So I'm going to select this one here. And as you can see, it's automatically inserted into our document. Now we want to change the size of this. We can just move this in and out if we want to. But if you have a particular size that you need, then you can select it, go to position, and then go over to this section here where you can simply enter in the exact size you want. So I'm just going to type 60 into here, and then I can just click anywhere and it will automatically change my height as well because this is a square frame. And you can also see that it's locked here as well. So once you're happy, you need to decide how many photographs you want. So we're going to go for 6. So select the image and go to this icon here that says duplicate. We're going to click this 5 times. And then we're just going to simply space these out. You don't need to be too accurate. I'll show you a quick way to how to tidy these up. So the most important thing is to roughly space your squares out. So top to bottom, they take up the amount of space you want on your document. So if I want them really close together, I'm going to space them close together. If I want them far apart, I'm going to do the top and the bottom one far apart, and I'll show you the reason why. If we then select these 3, we can go back up to position and we can go to something called tidy up. And if you click on that, it will automatically align those images. If I do the same over here with them being so spaced out, again, go to position and go to tidy up, we'll again tidy it up, but you can see how spaced out they are. So the important thing is to put the top and bottom one roughly where you want them. So on one side, we've got those tidied up here. So you need to try and align the top ones, and you can do that using the guides. It will click into place. And again, down the bottom here, the guides will click that into place and make sure it's level across the bottom. Then once again, don't worry about too much about the middle one. We can select them all and tidy them up, and they will all be perfectly aligned. Now to make sure the whole lot of these are lined up in the middle of your page, select them all, go to group, go back up to position, and go to center and middle. And that will ensure all of these are now perfectly lined up in the center of your document. Then go to ungroup, and now the fun can start with the images. So let's go back over to elements. And then we can either go down to photos and click see all, and then you can simply scroll through all the images you want. Or if you've got your own personal images, you can go to uploads, you can go to upload files, you can simply choose from any of your images. Let's say I want to select this one, click upload. And then as you can see, it's uploading here into my uploads. So now we just grab our image, we click and drag it across to one of our frames. I'm still holding my mouse down and it's actually gone into that square. Once it has, you can just release it. Now it may end up in a position you don't want. You might want to move this up or down. And in order to do that, you can double click. And once you have, you can see that you've now got the ability to move that picture up or down. Move it to exactly where you want it. And once you have, you can either press enter or click anywhere else. Now, if you don't like this photograph and you want to change it, so you can click on the image, you can go to more, and you can go down to detach image, and it will simply take the image out and place it in your document. If you don't want the image at all, you can either select it and press delete, or you can simply go to the delete icon here. Then you can just simply go ahead, click and drag another image across and do exactly the same. So I'm going to go ahead and just insert all the images I want. I'm just going to click and drag some from these stock images over here. And you can see they just glide in perfectly and I don't have to be too careful with them. Perfect. If they're not quite right, you can just move them. And then once again, if I tidy up all of them, so if I select all of them, go to position and select tidy up, it does this. So what you have to do, let's go back, Command or Control Z will go back one step, is actually just select a row or a column at a time and tidy those up. And then just make sure they're aligned to the top on each column. If I want to move the columns inward a little bit like this, I can do that. And again, I can group them all together. So I can actually select these, group this column together, so you can move this column around. Select this column, group that one, so that one's all grouped together. And now I can just move them around and they will click into place. You can see when I move these around how they will adjust and click into place. Again, you can select them all, group them, then go over and center them. If the middle one or any of these are grayed out, that means that it's already centered or it's already aligned, so you don't have to click it again. So if you now want to download this, you simply go to Share, Download, go to this drop-down menu here, pick from one of the file types that you want, and then simply go to Download. And then you can see here it's downloading, and it will therefore be in your downloads folder. So I hope that's helped you today. If it has, please like and subscribe and have a great day.